So this is experiment number 8, and this is from DevOps practical. So the title of this experiment number 8 is to understand a Docker architecture and container lifecycle. You have to install Docker and execute the Docker commands to manage the image and interact with the container. In short, in today's practical, we are going to learn what is Docker, how it works, what is container lifecycle. Then after installing Docker, we are going to learn the basic commands to run the Docker. Okay. So before that, I have sent one link to your CR and asked him to forward into your student group. So have you installed Docker in your laptop? Yes. Okay. So did it take some more time, that installation for Docker? Did it take more time? 15 minutes. Okay, one is saying 15 minutes. One are saying no, yes. Okay. Yeah, even Manish has installation failed. Okay, fine. So this is one way of installing Docker. It's like just, we install the software, any software from the directly from the internet. So what is the drawback over here is, for that you allocated the spaces, hardware spaces to it, right? And plus you install Docker in your laptop, not on the cloud somewhere. Okay, so this is one way of installing Docker. Now, second way of installing Docker is, if you remember, we install Terraform using AWS instance. Can you tell me the steps, not the command, first step, what we did when we opened the AWS account, what we did the first step to install Terraform? Install Terraform. Before key. Or forget about the Terraform. Let's say about the Kubernetes. We'll talk about the Kubernetes. So have you installed launch instance? Yes, key variable is there. But what about the launch instance? While downloading Kubernetes through AWS account, what was the first step? Search ktest, okay. And before that, ktest were there before that. Very basic step. EC2 instance. Yes, correct. So EC2 instance was the very first basic steps for downloading any software, like whether it is Terraform, Kubernetes, Docker, anything. So launch instance, yes. So in launch instance, you got a chance to select the server. Well, Linux were there, then Ubuntu were there, Red Hat Linux 2, then this thing, Amazon Linux 2 were there, and only Amazon Linux were there, okay? Then you used to select the respective requirements, respective server. Then you used to do some configuration, like select tag, then security group, etc. And after that, you used to connect EC2 with the PuTTY, okay, or with the SSH key, right? And then later, you used to download Kubernetes, Terraform, or anything from the internet, okay? So today also, what we are going to do is, we are going to launch instance. Though it is a DevOps program, okay, DevOps practical is there, but we are going to launch Docker through the Amazon instance, because what will happen is, in Viva, if external may ask you, like, which are the ways to download the Docker, and which are the which one will be very easy for you to download it. So your answer should be, there are two ways. The first one, you can directly download it from the internet. There is a website, so you can directly download it, and then you can perform operation on it. Then second one is, you can download it through the Amazon instance, AWS, okay? So what is the advantage is Amazon is what? You can download it, you can perform your respective operations, you can perform the commands, you can take a screenshot, and after finishing your project and after finishing your task, you can easily terminate it. Okay, so these are the two ways to download the Docker. So first we are going to see the theory part. What is Docker? What is Docker architecture, container lifecycle, and basic commands? Okay, so this is very easy. I think we have done the Docker and container lifecycle. At least we have learned the term Docker and container. Can you recollect it from your previous experiments or previous sessions? What is Docker and what is container? Whatever you know about these two terms, you can say it. Again, no technical definition is required. Whatever you know in your simple word, in a simple English term, you can say it. What is Docker and what is container? Is it tool? Is it programming language? Is it technology? What is it exactly? Just try to recollect it from the Kubernetes slide. If you remember, we saw a theory in the Kubernetes, and before going to the Kubernetes, we saw what is container, what is Docker, like that. Anyone? Toolkit. Okay, what is toolkit exactly? Pass missing, it's a platform. Okay, very good. So I'll go to the next one, that is first slide. What is Docker? So Docker, it's a container technology, is launched in 2013, and it's open source Docker engine. So what is exactly it is? It's a containerization software. Okay, it's a unique because it focuses on developers' requirement and system operators to separate the application dependency from the infrastructure. So what is containerization software? Can you tell me the difference between VM versus container? This one, this slide we have done previously, right? Virtual VM is virtual machine, and next one is container. This is the architecture of VM, and this is
ma'am, VM uses hardware, and this uses then another one is not uses hardware, it run on the software.
Exactly. Okay, one point is done. What about the others? Nitish is saying no hardware to assign. Where? No hardware to assign? In VM or in container? In container. Okay, correct. So in virtual machine, if you see, these first two layers are same. Server is there, host operating system is there. Okay. Now next one is hypervisor. So here in hypervisor, all thing is done based on the hardware part. Okay, like suppose if you want to install Ubuntu, so you have to allocate the respective hardware resources, respective hardware part to the Ubuntu, respective hardware part to the another server, like that. But whereas in container, you need not to allocate any hardware requirements or any hardware specification. It works on the software. Okay, so this is what the container is. So hence Docker engine is called as a containerization tool, because to work with the container, to launch container, we need this Docker software. Okay, see, even if you notice in the container architecture, Docker engine is there. Why Docker engine is there? Because it is known as a containerization software. Okay, so please note it down somewhere. In Viva, they may ask you, in this architecture, why Docker engine is there? Why not the other? So your answer should be Docker engine is a containerization software. So to work with the container, to launch container, to do anything with the container, we need Docker software. Okay, understood? Understood the difference between VM and container? Any doubt? You can type yes or no in the chat box. And please note down the question also. Then shall I go to the previous slide? Yes or no? Yes, okay. So this is what Docker. Here, two question may ask. What is Docker, first one? Then what is it open source? Yes, it's open source Docker engine. And where it is launched? It's launched in 2013. Now, one more thing is that first, Docker, it was initially developed for the Linux system only. Okay, it means Docker used to run only in the Linux system. And it was first successfully for the Linux environment. But now it is extended so that you can use it in Windows environment also. Okay, so in Viva, again, external may ask you, can you run Docker in Linux environment as well as in Windows environment? So your answer should be yes. Previously, it was only working for Linux, but now updates are there. And because of that, you can work in both Linux as well as in Windows. Okay, so for that, you can also say that, yes, we have successfully installed Docker. Right now, you have installed Docker on Windows, right? And it is working properly. Okay, so similarly, with the help of AWS, we are going to install Docker in the Linux environment. Understood? Any doubt in what is Docker and whether it is run in the Linux or in Windows environment like that? It is clear? Yes or no? Yes, is it clear? We can type yes or no. Yes, thanks. Okay, so next one is, now what is container or what is Docker container? So here, suppose if they ask you what is container, okay? So container and Docker container both have a same definition. Both are the different term, but they have a same meaning. Okay, so don't get confused. If in Viva, external ask one student, what is container? And same question he asked to the another student, like what is Docker container? So don't get confused. Both have the same meaning. So what is that? It's a standard unit of software. It's a lightweight, standalone, executable package of software. Now package means what? It contain, it have a application and its dependency and binary of the application. So that is what the container. It is a package which contains the application. Second thing, its dependency. And third one is binary of the application. So if you notice over here, see this one. This is what the container. Application and its dependency. And then binary of the application. So again in Viva, if they ask you what container consists, or which are the things are there in the container? So your answer should be application, its application and its binary file and its dependency. Okay, done. Understood what is container, what is Docker, difference between VM and container, and which one is better? Yes or no? Can you type please yes or no so that I'll go to the next slide? Yes, okay. Now next one is Docker architecture. So here you can see there are total three main parts are there. first one is client, Docker host, and the third one is registry. Okay, so first we'll see upon the client. What is client is? Client provides user interface to interact with the Docker daemon. See here, okay. So client is what it does. They simply tell Docker daemon to perform some task. This is the first part of the client. Now second one is Docker daemon. So what Docker daemon does is he take command from the task. So performing task means what? Running the images, creating the container. As you can see over here, images are there, containers are there, and this both client and Docker daemon, they interact with each other. Okay, so whenever we install the Docker, we both need the both Docker client and Docker daemon, they install by default. Understood? First this Docker client and Docker daemon. Should I repeat it once again? What is that Docker architecture? It's very easy if you see it. Yes or no? Repeat. Okay. First, tell me how many components you can see. How many components are there in Docker architecture? How many components are there in the Docker architecture? Can you please type it in the chat box? See the diagram and just tell me how many components are there in Docker architecture. Three components are there. Okay. So can you just tell me which one is the first one? Can you just list out the first, second, and third one? Just see the diagram and tell me. Client, Docker host registry, client host registry. Okay. Now there is one change. Client is the first component. Yes, it is correct. Okay. Whereas Docker host is second component, but while writing down in the paper or while giving answer, you should say Docker daemon as a second component. Okay. Docker host means what? It is nothing but a server where Docker daemon is there. But this is Docker daemon is the main component. Okay. And third one is correct. That is registry. Done. So now you know the three components. Now break the three components into one by one. First, we'll focus on client. So what client is, can you see these three arrows? What it indicates that? The three arrows or three lines, what it indicates? No, not the commands. Just focus on these three. Commands are there. Yes, it is there. Just focus on this one. Sorry. Connection. Yes. So it is connecting to which component? It is connecting to which component? You see the diagram and tell me. Daemon. Exactly. So here, this client is connecting to daemon. So can I say that a Docker client can interact with the Docker daemon through these lines or through this arrow? It means interaction is there. Can I say like that? Yes. So interacting means what? What they will ask? Interaction means what? They will ask, how are you? What are you doing like that? No. Obviously, they will ask, they will give commands. Okay. They will ask for the details. Correct. So here, this client, here you can see three commands are there. One is build, second one is pull, and next one is run. So what the client do? Client will simply give this command to Docker daemon. Client say that, hey, Docker daemon, build a Docker. Hey, Docker daemon, go and pull the image. Hey, Docker daemon, go and run the container. like that. So he will simply give commands to Docker daemon. Understood the task of Docker client? Just simply giving commands to Docker daemon. That's it. Done with the Docker client, the first component. Any doubt in Docker client? Yes or no? Any doubt in this Docker client part? No. Okay, good, clear. Now, so this is what the first part. Continue. Okay, this is the first part. Now focus on this one, Docker daemon. So Docker daemon, what he is doing, he's taking command from the client. So after taking command, what he will do? After taking command from the Docker client, what he will do? Suppose I'm giving you command do study, then what you will do? Execute them. Exactly. So you will perform that task. Okay. So what is the main task of Docker daemon? Is to take command from this client and perform the task. That's it. That is what the main task of Docker daemon. Understood? So now, whenever you install Docker, only two components come by default. One is Docker client and second one is Docker daemon. The task of Docker client is to give command to Docker daemon, and task of Docker daemon is to execute the commands or perform the task which is given by the Docker client. Okay, so these two components are understood, Docker client and Docker daemon. Yes. Okay, now there is one thing called as a registry. Now focus on this registry part. What is the meaning of registry? And not a technical definition. What is the meaning of registry or register like that in English term, normal? Records, exactly. So records means what? Can I say that they store the data, whatever related to your Docker. Store data, then they perform data, save data, like saving data. It is whatever related to your Docker. Okay. So similarly, here you can see there are some application like nginx is there. Okay. And these are some parts which will be there in the next practical. So it is a storage place for your Docker images. And it is nothing but a Docker hub that is managed only and only by the Docker. Okay, so this is a registry. Now here, go back to this Docker pull and Docker run command. Pull and run command. Achha, in GitHub, what is the meaning of pull request or pull and push command? Forget about the GitHub. What is a pull and push command? What is pull and push? Try to imagine your GitHub account. We used to pull the repository, push the repository. Means what we were exactly doing at that time? Pull to merge code into main repository. Exactly. So pull means what? Who was pulling? GitHub account was pulling repository from local machine, right? And local machine was simply pushing the repository to the GitHub account, that is online account, correct? So similarly over here also, git pull or Docker pull is nothing but download the image. First, what he will do, he will interact with the daemon, okay? And then they will download the image. Suppose, for example, I'm writing one message in the chat box. Because Docker pull is equal to A. Means what? Docker pull, Docker client give command to Docker daemon to download the image. and the image name is A. Okay, so now what Docker daemon do? Docker daemon will check whether the image A is there in the local machine or not. Suppose image A is not there, then what he will do? He will go to the registry, he will download that image A, and then he will again run that image A into the Docker daemon. This is what the task of Docker pool is, to give command to Docker daemon. Docker daemon will check whether that image on container is there in the local machine or not. If it is not there, he will go to registry, he will download that image or container, he will come back again, and then he will perform the task. Understood? Docker pool and Docker run. Any doubt in how it works? Docker pool, Docker run. Yes or no? You can type in the chat box. Or else we'll do one thing, we'll do quick revision on architecture. Is that okay? So that the doubts or queries are there, that will be clear. Yes, revise. Okay, we'll start from the very basic. How many components are there, and just please list down the components. How many components are there in the Docker architecture? See the diagram and tell me. Client, host, registry. Client, daemon, registry. Yes, correct. Now, first one, we'll focus on client. What is the main task of Docker client? I'll give you two options. Is to give command or to run the command. Give command or run command. Give command. Okay, so this is done. Now, by looking at the diagram, can you tell me how many commands are there in the Docker client? Three commands. And which are they? Build, pull, and run. Okay, so first part is done. Now go to the second part, that is Docker host. First thing, Docker daemon. Okay, now what is Docker host? Before going to Docker daemon, what is Docker host? What is Docker host? It is a server. Okay, it's a server where Docker daemon is reside, or Docker daemon is there. Understood? Now, what is Docker daemon? What is the main task of Docker daemon? Is to take command or to is to take command and perform the task, or to simply give command? Take command. Okay, and take command from whom? From registry or from client? From client. Okay, so this part is done now for client and Docker host. Okay, correct. Now the second one, we'll go to the third part, that is registry. So what is the use of registry, or what is registry exactly? What is registry? Record. It maintain the record, it save or store the data. Okay, or images, you can say that, which is managed only and only by Docker. Okay, so now if you know the components, or now you know the task of each and every component. Okay, now there is only one thing. Suppose Docker pool asked Docker daemon, he gave one task. Okay, is to please download the image and run the image. Okay, so second part, what Docker daemon will do, he will see whether ABC image is there in the Docker host or not. Docker is nothing but a server, right? So whether the ABC image is there in the Docker host or not. Suppose if that image is not there, then what a Docker daemon will do, if that respective image is not there, then what a Docker daemon will do if client is giving command to Docker daemon is go and download the ABC image. He will go to registry. Exactly. What he will do, he will go to registry. He will download that ABC image. He will come back to Docker host. And then here in the Docker host, he will run the ABC image. Understood? That's it. That is how Docker architecture works. If anything is not here in the server machine, he will go to registry and he will download it from the registry and then he will simply execute it into the Docker host. Clear? Docker architecture. Yes. Okay. So shall I go to the next slide? Yes. Okay. So now next is the container life cycle. So this just for this time, just simply see these are the container life cycle is nothing but the commands, Docker versions, Docker images, Docker PS, PS slash A dash A. These are the commands which are there. Okay. So we'll see the commands in detail in the next practical. Okay. For now, just have a look. What is the container lifecycle? So total 4 commands are there. Okay, just simply have a look. So now we'll start with installing the or we'll launching the instance. So please open your Amazon account or AWS account and click on the launch instance. We are going to repeat the same procedure. Please go back to your AWS account. Type EC2 instance. In that, click on EC2 instance. On the right hand side at the top, in orange color, there is a launch instance button. So please click on it and let me know once you are finished with it. Go back to AWS account and there is a launch instance like we did it for Terraform, Kubernetes. We are going to again install Linux software through AWS account. So are you getting this screen? This one, choose Amazon machine language or machine image. Step one. Yes, okay. So now again, here we are going to select the first one, Amazon Linux 2 AMI. Okay, okay. Now here, don't take a screenshot of it because we have already took a screenshot for the previous, for the Kubernetes. So we are going to repeat the same procedure. Rank with selecting the first one, Amazon Linux to AMI. Yes, okay. Now here, choose instance type. So t2.micro will come by default since we are using free tier eligible account. So click on it. After that, click on the configure instance detail. Next one. Configure instance detail. Here, no need to do anything. Keep all the details as it is. Click on the next one, that is add storage. Here also there is no need to do anything. Now here one question external may ask, can we change the size of this thing, GIB? Can we change the size? What will be your answer? Can we change the size? Yes. Okay, and it depends on which thing, which parameter our project requirement. Yes, up to 30 GIB, correct. And it depends only and only our project requirement. Okay. So please click on the next one. That is add tag. Now here, click on the add new tag. The key is name. And inside the value, please type Docker. I'm referring this Terraform wala screenshot. So that's where Terraform value is there. But you can type, repeat once. Okay. See, after this, wait a minute. After this, click on add tag. Here, click on add tag button. Inside the key, give name, key name. And then inside the value, please give Docker as a value. I am referring this previous slide, that is Terraform wala. So please don't write Terraform. Please write Docker. And after that, click on configure security group. No, don't take screenshot. We'll take a screenshot later. Now here, SSH will be there by default. Okay. So please click on add rule and select all traffic. And in the same all traffic row, select anywhere source. All traffic and anywhere.
Can you repeat the previous tag, add tag?
This one? Okay. So here first click on add tag. Then inside the key type name and AME this. And inside the value type Docker. Because we are performing Docker. Actually, you can give any value. Okay. But just only for our convenience, we are giving the name as per the experiment. So right now we are performing Docker experiment. That is why we are giving a Docker value. After that, click on configure security group. Here, SSH, this will be there by default. You just need to add one more rule. So please click on add rule. Select all traffic in the same row. For all traffic, select sources anywhere. And once you are finished with configuring the security group, click on review and launch. They will ask for the existing key pair. So we have already created the key pair. So your selected key pair will come here by default. Simply click on this one, I acknowledge part. and then after that launch instance. And then just scroll down, click on view instance. So here the Docker in will come. So instead of Terraform, you will see a Docker instance.
Ma'am, after security group, what we have to do?
After security group, so after security, you will get this message. Select the existing key pair or create new key pair. Click on review and launch, and you will get this message. So here your existing key pair will be there. Click on I acknowledge this button.
Ma'am, I don't get this message. I've got something else.
What you are getting?
Ma'am, AMI detail, Amazon Linux 2 AMI, then
instance. Then just scroll down.
There will be a
launch instance like that, some button will be there.
Ma'am, then intense type, security group, or...
Right corner launch button is there, click on that.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Now you will get this message, this one, this screen. Existing key pair and create new key pair. So make sure you're selecting existing key pair is there. Click on I acknowledge, launch instance. And after that, you will get Docker and instance status running. If you're getting this screen, so now you can take a screenshot of it. This will be your first screenshot for experiment number 8. Yes, you have to take a screenshot. Here, Docker will come, right? So highlight this part and take a screenshot of this whole instance. It shows that you have successfully launched the instance. Done. Shall I go to the next slide? Yes, okay. Now what you have to do is open your command prompt. And then after that, repeat the same procedure. Here, change first directory, cd desktop. After that, type SSH space dash I. This is my PAME file name, that is ubuntu.pame, ec2 dash user, @, and IP address.
So what will be the location for command prompt?
Sorry.
Can you repeat this step, command prompt?
First open command prompt from your Windows, cmd, type cmd in the search.
Yes, ma'am.
Done. Now type cd desktop first. Matlab you are changing directory.
Ma'am, that ID will be different.
Sorry?
Ma'am, the user ID will be different or same?
It will be different only. Just simply type this one, cd desktop, not the previous one.
No, ma'am. After changing a directory, the /ubuntu.pam.
This ID, no? You will get this ID. Wait a minute.
Public instance, ma'am.
Exactly. Just simply select this Terraform and copy the address, public IP address. That will be different. And even your PAME file name is also different. Here, Ubuntu is my PAME file name. Your PAME file name will be different. So simply type this line, SSH space dash I space Ubuntu dot PAME space EC2 dash user at the rate your IP address. After that, they will ask, are you sure you want to continue? So please type yes, and then you are connected to the instance. Done. So those who have done, please take a screenshot and highlight this part. No need to highlight this CD desktop. Just simply highlight this part. Yeah, those who have finished, please take a screenshot and highlight the key part, SSH key, this one.
Hello, ma'am.
Huh?
We can also use the connect button, no? Over AWS EC2.
Which one?
Connect button is there, no? It will open command and new tab.
Yeah, you can try it. Hi, I don't think it will work. Just try it.
Yeah, it is working.
It is working. Can you show the screen? I'll just simply stop sharing.
Yes.
Because this is the first was we have to, you know, open the PuTTY app, then again connect SSH and like that. Then this was the second one.
This screen is visible.
Hi, now it is visible.
Yeah, I'm telling this disconnect.
Okay, and then after that.
This again connect. See.
Whoa. Nice, that's great. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
So next time onwards, we'll do with the things. Now you have, now you know, three ways are there to connect your EC2 instance. Thanks, Mitesh.
Welcome.
Okay, so now we'll go with the next one. So that's great. Like you know, explore the new options which is there in the AWS, and that's very good. So please take a screenshot. So from next time onwards, we'll follow the Nitesh step. Now next one is we have to update the respective Docker in the Linux. Okay. So here you will see there is one command called the sudo yum update dash y. So please type this command. Or I'll do one thing. I'll copy the command and paste it. Just wait a minute. That will be better. Yes, please type this command. One of your friend is saying you can also right click the instance and connect using SSH. Wow, very good. That's really nice. You guys simply study this DevOps and advanced DevOps more, because right now it is a very most trending topic. And after 1 year, like in the next year only, in company, you may get a good opportunity to work on this respective, you know, fields. That's very good. So done with this sudo yum update and y command. Is what you're exactly doing, you're simply updating the installing packages. That's it. Is it okay to... Yes, it's okay if you connect it through AWS. See, connecting is very important. Yes, it's okay. But make sure to take a screenshot of it, okay? So once you are finished, please take a screenshot and highlight this command. first one. Done. Any doubt in the first command? So in Viva, they may ask you which command you use to update the packages. So your answer should be this command: sudo yum update dash space y. Shall I go to the next one? Next command. Type yes or no in the chat box. Yes, shall I go to the next command? Okay, so your next command is sudo amazon linux extra install docker. So install docker, so it means that to install the latest version of docker in amazon linux 2. Okay, only in the amazon linux 2 we are using this command. So I'll copy this command, paste it in the chat box. So please write this command in the command prompt. You will get this message: installing Docker, then plugins are loading and everything like that. Are you getting output? Yeah. Done. It is successfully installed, right? So please take a screenshot and highlight this command, this one. So to install Docker, we are using, but only on the Amazon Linux 2, not on the other thing. And why Amazon Linux 2? Because that instance we have launched. Okay, suppose if we launch the Amazon Linux instance. Okay, so for that different command is there. See, this is the command is only for the Amazon Linux. Okay, so via this command also you can install Docker, but for that Amazon Linux instance should be there. Right now we are using Amazon Linux 2. Just keep that thing in mind. Suppose in Viva external may ask you, can I use this command in Ubuntu or in other instance? So your answer should be no. This command is applicable only and only for Amazon Linux 2. Whereas the command which I have just posted in the chat box, that command is applicable only for Amazon Linux. Got it? Okay. So once you start reading the documentations, no, for respective commands for respective instances, you will come to know that every instance has their own command. Now we'll go to the next one. Now just to make sure whether it is Docker is installed or not, you can type this command. They will say that all it is already installed. This is for optional thing, just to make sure whether it is installed or not. There is no need to take a screenshot for this command. Just simply type. Are you getting this message? Like package Docker is already installed and the latest version, nothing to do like that. Are you getting it? Yes, okay. Permission denied. Have you write this command, this one, the previous one? sudo amazon linux this one. How come CMD is not connecting? Then do one thing. Okay, share your screen. Can you zoom? To do one thing, open your AWS account. Now here, see, connect option is there on the top. Connect instance state. Beside the instance state. Connect. No, not that one, the connect one. Now go back, click on connect option. Now wait. Now type here. Can you please stop sharing your screen? Now type the commands like sudo apt and that all this. Sudo yum update y. Do this one. This command.
YUM.
See, I posted a command in the chat box. That one, huh? Now wait. After that, there is one more command to install Docker that I've just posted in the chat box. So copy that command and paste it in the CMD, in that screen only. Correct. Now install Docker. You can take screenshot. You can take screenshot later. Okay. So can you please stop sharing your screen? Thanks. So now Docker is installed successfully. We'll go to the next slide. Here there is no need to take a screenshot. Just to make sure whether it is installed or not, you can use this command. Okay. Next one is, please type this one, sudo service docker start. This command is used to start a Docker service. I'll copy this command. This one. After that, you will get this message, redirect into bin systemctl and start Docker service. So are you getting this one, this line, after entering sudo service docker start? Yes, okay. Now don't take a screenshot, we'll perform one command and later you can take a screenshot for the whole commands, okay? Now after that, there is this command is there, sudo user mode. AG Docker EC2. So what is that? We are simply adding EC2 user to the Docker group. Okay, so that's why we are using this command. So please type this command. This one. This command shows that we are adding Sorry, just wait a minute. Please type this command. Presentation. Just wait a minute. Done. Okay, so those are finished. Please take a screenshot for both the command. Is my screen visible? Yes, okay. So done with taking the screenshot for both the commands. Okay, so now what you have to do is you have to close command prompt. Okay, and those who have connected through Amazon service now, you have to simply close the tab and then again reconnect it. Means kya karna hai aapko, close the command prompt and then again reconnecting it like this. Close the command prompt and then again open the command prompt. Those who have done with using AWS account, close that connect tab, that is second tab, and again reopen it. Just reconnect it to the EC2 user. Done. Those who have doing it in the CMD, you know, command prompt, close this tab, this one. So close this tab and then again open it, open that tab and again reconnect it to the EC2 user.
Ma'am, we can do it by opening a new CMD by just skipping that and then doing and then copy pasting the same thing.
Opening and closing, you can do it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, okay. So once you're finished, please type this docker info command. Only this two words command. And click on enter button, then you will get the information related to docker. So those who have done with reconnecting it, please type docker info command. There is a space between them and then you will get the information related to docker. Are you getting the information like this? Client, server, container, zero. See, everything will come zero because we are simply creating the docker. Nothing is there. There is no container, no images, nothing is there. Okay, yes, okay. So please take a screenshot of whole, make sure this whole at least half information is there below the docker info and take a screenshot like this and highlight this docker info.
Ma'am, in last it is giving warning. Is it okay?
Warning as in after the swarm inactive.
Ma'am, in last after executing the Docker info command, last of the execution, it is giving warning. In first, I am able to see like you like containers.
Ah, this one. So this information is there, right? This one.
Yes, ma'am.
Then it's okay. Then it's okay. Done. Okay. So now, please type this message: sudo service docker status. So after typing this command, we'll come to know that whether our Docker is in active state or is it non-active state. So you will see it is in green color. It is active, that is in running state. Please type this command: sudo service docker status. Click on enter button and then you will get this message. So are you getting this active running state, this one, and green color over here? Yes, correct. So what it means that your Docker is in active state. Okay, so in Viva, if they ask you which state or which command is there to represent or to indicate whether your Docker is in running state or not, so this one, sudo service docker status. So those are finished. Please take a screenshot,
ma'am. Ma'am, by mistake I closed the command prompt, so we have to I have to again run the docker info command.
Nahi, it's okay.
Okay, ma'am.
You simply type this command: sudo service docker status. Docker info means what? They are simply giving the information related to your Docker, like what is there right now. Nothing is there, right? That is why everything, container running, pause, stop, 00, you can see here server version is there, supports, you type information related to your Docker, that's it.
After, ma'am, connecting? No, ma'am, after git
after
connecting to the AWS account, then I give the command.
After that, you can directly give this command: sudo service docker status. Okay, so now there is one last command here: sudo docker images. So please type this command: sudo docker images. Actually, you can type there are two commands. First one is docker images, second one is sudo docker images. Here you can see the output of two commands are same only, so you can choose any one and you can type any one in the command prompt. You can go for the sudo docker images or you can also go for the docker images. Here you will see only the title of respective images, because nothing is created, right? That is why everything is empty. Only titles are there: repository, tag, image ID, created, size, like that. So are you getting this title, image ID, created, size, and everything like that? Yes, correct. So please take a screenshot. There is no need to type the two commands. Okay, you can choose any one command. The outputs are same only. So please take a screenshot of it, because no images are created. That's why nothing is there. Then, so understood what Docker is. Only I think of. Pull and push and only I think 3 to 4 basic commands are there. So we'll do that commands in the next practical. in the next practical we'll finish experiment number 8, like the only I think 20% portion is there for the experiment 8 and experiment number 9. So we'll finish two practicals of DevOps in the next practical. So up to this, do you have any doubt related to Docker, container, Docker architecture and command, and then launch instance? Any doubt till now in this practical experiment number 8? You can type yes or no in the chat box, so I'll come to know that. No doubt. Okay, so don't forget, this is DevOps practical. We are simply using AWS just to launch Docker. Okay, so now there is one more thing I want to ask is, on Saturday, do you have any extra lecture?
I'm having Microsoft lecture for certification.
So you have Java, then TPO training in IIT, Microsoft, the whole Saturday. IIT, अच्छा for software engineering, हाँ for software engineering you have IIT one, okay. 5:30 to 9:30. At the evening you have 5:30 to 9:30.
Yes, ma'am.
5:30 to 9:30 lecture, okay, okay. So whole Saturday you are packed, right? So what I'll do is, like, is it okay for you if I simply add 2-3 commands and then I'll make a PPT of it and then I'll upload it on the ERP? So can you follow the same steps? Like, iske baad hi hum log ko khali wo 2-3 commands hi add karne. Can you do that? Because I wanted to take one lecture. I'll give.
No, we can do now also, no.
Huh?
We can do now also, no.
Ha, but you know what will happen is, already we are Docker images and containerization terms, no, they are new to you, okay? So I don't want keep matlab aap aage ka bhi kar rahe ho to piche ka bhi, you know, pura get complicated or confused ho jao. So I just want you to just listen it very, you know, specifically and do it aaram se waise karke. Only I think 2 or 3 commands are there. Yeah, okay, I'll do one thing. I'll take a screenshot and I'll write the instructions. You just simply follow it. And next time we have to do, because next time we'll go to the experiment number 9. I wanted to take one extra lecture on Saturday. I think on Sunday also there is some lecture, right? For you?
Ma'am.
Yes or no?
For AI lecture, ma'am, that my Microsoft courses.
Yes, yes, and take your training. So your placement trainings have started, your interview and GDP round sessions, all thing will be there, right? So we'll do one thing then, I'll simply make a PPT and upload it on the ERP and then you just follow that commands. So for that, what you have to do is, you have to again open the launch the instance, okay? Your Jenkins error, na? Shubham, do one thing. You share your screen. We'll try to solve the error, because Manish and one more student were there at that time. He also got the same error, and they solved it and they got the answer. I don't know why you're not getting answer. I'll stop sharing my screen and just share your screen, Shubham. We'll see the Jenkins error. Yes, we'll do one thing. We'll help Shubham to solve the errors. And then I'll save your attendance and then you may leave now. So open it, huh? So don't build account. Just do one thing, go to the dashboard, manage Jenkins. No, only Java error you are getting, Java error, right? Yes. Then go to the manage Jenkins, manage Jenkins. Fourth option. Global tool. Now JDK installation. JDK, click on JDK installation. And scroll down. Select the latest version, the 9.0 is there. Okay. No, don't go there. It's okay. You simply go to Jenkins. And now what error you're getting, just scroll up. Have you uninstalled Git? Git is there, okay. Please terminate the AWS instance. Thanks for reminding. If you want to explore it, you have a time right now. You can explore the AWS instance. Why don't you go try again? So installing Docker on the another thing, like on the Ubuntu or something like that. If you want to explore it, it's okay, or else simply click on instance and terminate it. Don't click on the stop instance, click on the terminate instance. Okay, then only you will instance will get terminated. Shivam, only you were there, right? In last lecture when we were solving problems. Manish were there in the first thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Only you were there, right? You also got the same error, right?
Yes, ma'am. I just installed the JDK correct version.
Can you please help me?
Ma'am, simply update this and after that.
Arey, he did it, you know.